This is the first of two videos on using orthogonal bases. In this video, we'll talk about how you can use orthogonal bases to decompose vectors. In the next video, we'll talk about how to use them to decompose operators. So to begin with, a set of vectors is orthogonal if any two different ones are orthogonal. That is to say, if you take the inner product of any two different guys in the list, you get zero. Now, we're going to look at an orthogonal basis. Suppose we have an n-dimensional vector space with some inner product. It doesn't have to be the standard inner product. And we have a basis that consists of orthogonal vectors. Now, the wonderful thing about inner products is that it allows us to decompose a vector in the basis. If I give you any vector in the vector space, you're going to want to write it as some constant times the first basis vector plus some constant times the nth basis vector and all the terms in between. Now, if we take the inner product of both sides with b1, or rather take the inner product of b1 with x, that's the inner product of b1 with this whole combination. And because the inner product is linear, that's c1 times the inner product of b1 with itself, plus c2 times the inner product of b1 with b2, and so on. But the inner product of b1 with b2 is 0. The inner product of b1 with b3 is 0. The inner product of b1 with bn is 0. All these terms go away, and you're left with just c1 times the inner product of b1 with itself. Well, that means that c1 must be the inner product of b1 with x divided by the inner product of b1 with itself. And likewise, c2 is the inner product of b2 with x divided by the inner product of b2 with itself. And in general, each coefficient is going to be given by the inner product of bk with your vector divided by the inner product of bk with itself. So, for example, let's suppose that we're looking at the vector. We're in R3 with a standard inner product. We're looking at, you're going to use the basis 1, 1, 1, 1, minus 1, 0, and 1, 1, negative 2. This is going to be our running example, and you can readily check that these vectors are orthogonal. If somebody gave us a vector 6, 2, negative 5, and said to decompose it in this basis, well, you could set up the three equations and three were unknowns and then start row reducing. Or maybe you could set up the change of basis matrix and try to invert it. But it's easier to just use inner products. The inner product of b1 with x is 6 plus 2 minus 5, that's 3. But the inner product of b1 with itself is 1 plus 1 plus 1, that's 3. 3 over 3 is 1, so our first coefficient is 1. Inner product of b2 with x is 6 minus 2 plus 0, that's 4. Inner product of b2 with itself is 2. So our second coefficient is 4 divided by 2, that's 2. Our third coefficient, we take the inner product of b3 with x, get 18. Inner product of b3 with itself is 6. The ratio is 3. So that means that our vector must be 1 times b1 plus 2 times b2 plus 3 times b3. And you can check that if you take this vector plus twice this vector plus 3 times this vector, you really and truly do get this vector. So without doing any row reduction, without doing any matrix inversion, just by using inner products, we got the decomposition of x in the B basis. Now, in general, if you have a vector that you can decompose in the B basis, you might want to look at each piece separately. You see, the piece, you know, the CKBK is the amount of x that's pointing in the BK direction. And we call that the projection of x onto BK. Or sometimes we call it the vector projection, because sometimes people use the word scalar projection for something else. And we're going to denote it P sub BK x. See, P sub BK is an operator. It takes a vector, and it spits out the part of the vector that's pointing in the BK direction. Let's see if we can figure out what this operator is. You see, CK is given by our formula, inner product of BK with X divided by the inner product of BK with itself. So if you write CK times BK, I could just as well write that as BK times CK, because this is just a number I can put on either side. and bk is a ket. And now I write my inner products this way. And I'm going to rearrange it. I'm going to think of it as this operator acting on x. And let's think about what this operator means. It means you take x, you take its inner product with bk. That's what the bra means, the inner product of bk with x. Then you multiply by the vector bk, and you divide by the inner product of bk with itself. That gives you an operator, and it takes any vector, and it spits out the piece of the vector pointing in the x direction, in the bk direction. In other words, the projection in the bk direction is this outer product of a ket times a bra divided by the inner product, which is a bra times a ket. So in our example, we looked at the basis, these three vectors, b1, b2, and b3. If you take just b1, as a ket, it's 1, 1, 1. As a bra, it's the transpose conjugate. Now, these are real numbers, so when you conjugate them, they don't change. But in principle, it's the transpose conjugate. And the projection operator is given by the column times the row. This is a 3x1 matrix. This is a 1x3 matrix. You multiply them together, and you get a 3x3 matrix. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. You divide that by the product of a 1x3 and a 3x1. That's a number. That number is 3. So you get a third of this matrix. So this is the projection operator. And likewise, if you wanted to project onto B2, the denominator is 2. The outer product of B2 of, you know, if I take the ket B2 times the bra B2, I get this matrix. So the projection is equal to this. For B3, you get that. And you may notice that if you add those three matrices together, you get the identity. And this is no coincidence. Because if you take any vector, which is the identity times the vector, each vector is the piece of the vector in the B1 direction, plus the piece of the vector in the B2 direction, plus the piece of the vector in the B3 direction. So whatever you get by projecting in the B1 direction, plus whatever you get by projecting in the B2 direction, plus whatever you get by projecting in the B3 direction, must be whatever you get by applying the identity matrix. So PB1 plus PB2 plus PB3 must be the identity matrix. Okay. Finally, we're going to talk about something even better than orthogonal bases. That's orthonormal bases. If you take an orthogonal basis and you rescale each vector so that it's a unit vector, that is to say, the inner product of any vector with itself is 1, and the inner product of any vector with a different vector is 0, we call that an orthonormal basis. And if you have an orthonormal basis, then whenever you did your expansions, well, we have our formula. But the denominator is 1. If the denominator is 1, you can ignore it. So you don't have to take an inner product and divide. You just take an inner product. And this number is what is sometimes called the scalar projection of x onto bk. And it's sometimes called the component of x in the bk direction. And the projection operator is just the outer product of bk with itself. So instead of it being the bra times a ket, it's a ket times a bra. It's a column times a row, and that gives you a matrix. And the identity is the sum of these outer products. So orthonormal bases work just like orthogonal bases, only a little bit better.